Gabi po sa inyong lahat. I'm Manny Lopez. I'm the group called the Christian Peace Alliance. This is a broad-based group of concerned and discerning citizens. And we formed this group purposely to oppose and reject the bounds of our basic law. We have 10 reasons why we oppose the Bangsa Moro Basic Law. And the first among these reasons is the BBL is a Malaysian design. The BBL mandates a parliamentary form of government that is patterned after Malaysia. And the head of state, whom they refer to as chief minister, will have a parity of esteem, or he will effectively be in the same category as a head of state. Thirdly, the BBL mandates the MILF as the transition authority. The Aquino administration is imposing on the MILF to assume supreme leadership during the transition process from the arm, which will become, which will be abolished upon the passage of the BBL into law, and replace this with a Bangsa Moro entity. Now, the Bangsa Moro entity will be another layer in the structure of leadership, which is distinct and different from the presidential form of government. Despite of the enormous cost of maintaining and funding this extra layer of bureaucracy, it does not guarantee that social services, resources, will be efficiently delivered to the citizens of the region, whether they're Christians, Muslims, or Lumans. There are also other pertinent issues, such as the Bangsa Moro Police and the Coast Guard, which is independently organized and operationalized, subject to the requirements of the Bangsa Moro leadership. Now, what is actually causing a lot of concern are the allegations that the passage of the BBL is being financed by foreign interests. In this case, that is Malaysia. Now, let me ask you, is Malaysia doing this purposely to help the Filipino people, in particular the Filipino Muslims in Mindanao? I don't think so, ladies and gentlemen. There are over 500,000 Filipinos in Sabah, and they are badly treated. We have seen a delegation, representatives of the Sultanate of Sulu, going back to their own territory, to their own land. And what happened? They were practically wiped off by the Malaysian armed forces. Now, we can conclude that Malaysian interest in the BBL is not really for the Filipino Muslims. It is for their own strategic positioning. They need the buffer state to ensure their claim or occupation of Sabah will be permanent. And that is the real reason why they're putting in a lot of time and resources to ensure that there is a Malaysian influence or controlled entity within the Filipino territory. This is not a question of faith. This is a question of strategic positioning and vested commercial interest. Let me ask you, or let us review the history of Sabah. In 1887, Sultan Jamalul Kiram entered into a pajak, a lease agreement, with the Baron Overdeck and Alfred Deck, both British citizens. It was not the same, since Malaysia up to this time is paying the lease rental of 7,600 Malaysian rupees. Up to now. So it is a lease, a pajak, using the Malay terminology. In 1947, over there, and then bequeathed the sovereignty, the title to the British Crown. Ibinigay po nila yung titulo ng Sabah sa British Crown, and consequently, the British Crown assumed sovereignty over Sabah. E ganun po yun. Ipinalis ang Sabah kay Overdeck at kay Deck, at noong 1947, ibinigay nila ito sa British Crown. And in 1963, the Federation of Malaysia was invented and Sabah was included in the Federation of Malaysia. Whereas the ownership, the proprietary rights of Sabah still belong to the Sultanate of Sulu. And as citizens of the Republic of the Philippines, the government of the Republic of the Philippines has the duty and responsibility to ensure that the proprietary rights, at the very least, of the Sultanate of Sulu,
ang kilatas international
with fervor and with commitment. Unfortunately, in 1987, effectively our claim to Sabah, our sovereign claim of Sabah, was dropped. For whatever reason, I don't agree on that policy. In 2012 or 2014, the Sultanate of Sulu sent its representatives to Sabah to lay its claim on their property. And you know what happened to this brave man, to the brave Tausu, who went back to reclaim their own land. Now, what do we do with the BPM? There is a clamor for autonomy. There is a clamor for social justice. There is a clamor for development and equitable progress. And all these clamors are legitimate. But you cannot do that by just talking to one group that does not truly represent the aspirations of the Moro people in Mindanao. There has to be discussion points. All stakeholders